Israel has resumed combat in Gaza, claiming Hamas violated the operational pause and also fired a rocket towards an Israeli border city. It comes after a week-long ceasefire that saw dozens of hostages released and a brief reprieve for the people of Gaza.
For 7 days, the skies over Gaza were quiet. That silence now broken. Israel accusing Hamas of firing a rocket towards the city of Sderot and violating the ceasefire agreement. The IDF now resuming airstrikes on the strip. It brings an end to the tense pause that saw dozens of hostages released. Fears now for the more than 130 left in Gaza. Just hours earlier, there were tears of relief. As the mother of French-Israeli hostage Mia Shem learned her daughter would be set free after 55 days in captivity. The ordeal finally over for the 21-year-old, back in the arms of her mum and brother. She was one of two hostages released by Hamas in the 24-hour truce extension, which came down to the wire.
Others let go hours later.
Another 30 Palestinians released from jail in exchange. It's believed most, not all, children have been released. Efforts to extend the ceasefire were ultimately unsuccessful, despite a push from US Secretary of State Antony Blinken, who flew to Israel for the first time since the pause in fighting began, holding a series of top-level meetings, including with Benjamin Netanyahu. I told him, I swore to eliminate Hamas. Nothing will stop us, the Israeli Prime Minister says. Talks too with Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas. As the violence resumed in Gaza, the West Bank also saw flare-ups. Vision emerging of the moment two gunmen opened fire at a Jerusalem bus stop.
Gunshots from two terrorists in a car.
Killing three and injuring 16 before being killed by off-duty Israeli soldiers and a civilian. Hamas quickly claiming responsibility and calling for an escalation in resistance. Edward Godfrey, Nine News.